why do you think it's so important to have a festival like this that celebrates the magnificent and varied genre of horror?
Well, you just answered it. I don't know. Like when I grew up in the suburbs of San Diego, I never imagined that they had things like this. It would have blown my mind if I'd known that I'd be visiting one, you know, in London. It's just crazy because it's like, I think in a lot of places, people don't always have a place to sort of gather and kind of just have fun and have the communal feeling of watching a horror film. And, you know, it's different when you go to the theater and it's just like a bunch of average people that maybe don't even give a fuck. They're just out there because, oh, it's a Friday night, whatever, take my girl. Some people are just there to kind of make fun of the movie. It's, you know, it's not always, you're not all there because you love it, you know. And it's kind of cool here to see people in it for the right reasons, you know. And it's serious. It's like a church, you know. But it's really cool, man. I've been to, like, Fantasia Fest has elements of this, but this is very different. And I think the fact that it's over one weekend makes it really, really concentrated. And, you know, people feel it's very immediate. So it's a cool experience.
Can you tell us a little bit about your contribution to the festival this year? Can you give us a quick synopsis of the film to start with?
So the film's called Cheap Thrills. I wouldn't say it's horror per se, but it's, you know, it's a black comedy made by somebody that's definitely a horror fan. It's about how far people are willing to go to do what they think is the right thing, how far they're willing to go to pay the rent and do all the basic stuff that we feel like we have to do as adults at some point. And, you know, it's a morality play, and it's just a really twisted, you know, house party.
What was it like making that house party? What was it like on set?
Super crazy. It was because there's a lot of balls in play. You know, you have special effects, you have dogs, you have babies, you have knives, you have stunts. People are punching each other and kicking. And, you know, it's not like the movie Carnage. It's like people don't, at some point they stop having conversations and they start, you know, throttling each other. So it gets very claustrophobic, you know, because you have essentially one room to do a lot of very physical things. So it's tough because you're trying to keep on restaging stuff and make sure that it doesn't get boring, because you're just essentially, you could just be filming a wall, you know, people just standing there talking heads. So it's tough. It's really tough, but you learn a lot. It's very fast. Well, it's like, it's interesting because it's like, I figured out, like, what if you had like a douchey after hours kind of coke party, but it was sort of directed by Toby Hooper. So you have that, hey, things are fun, but there's that manic humor and that weird violent energy and things are kind of screwed up. I took a lot of inspiration from a lot of European thrillers, a lot of Refn, you know, Haneke, von Trier, you know, a lot of newer Friedkin stuff, you know, Ben Wheatley's stuff I thought was really interesting tonally, you know, like, but just something that could be comical and sinister simultaneously, not necessarily like a horror comedy where it's just, hey, it's just a laugh the whole time, but gruesome, but to have it actually have an underpinning of tension and feel like maybe wrong, but you're still laughing, even, you know, it might mean that you're a bad person. I didn't really say that.
Final question, what's next for you? Have you got anything else lined up at the moment?
Yeah, I'm doing ABC's of Death 2, and I'm working on a thriller script with Pat Healy, one of the leads of Cheap Thrills. We're going to do that with the producer of Your Next. So hopefully do that next year.